Hi, today's project are these beautiful lace covered jars. These make wonderful vases or jars to hold your knickknacks or become a coin jar. They're just really beautiful, so they make a wonderful centerpiece or a gift. They're just very, very pretty to make, and they're just so beautiful because everyone can be done differently. We're going to use a variety of laces and trims to make these. We're going to use anything from a corded re-embroidered lace to Venices. You can use basic polyester laces and ribbons. The key to making these are to have a mixture of different textures and colors on your laces and trims so that they all stand out separately from each other. So the first thing you want to do is you need to have your mason jar. You can do this on any size jar that you want to use. I'm using the larger quart jar, but you can certainly use smaller ones. But we're going to use the basic quart jar. You want to measure from the neck right here down to the bottom of your jar so you know what size to cut your lace, because we want to do a base lace to cover up our jar first. So I measured from here down to here, and then I measured around the widest part of my jar so I would know what size lace I want to wrap around here. So I've got a jar that I've already wrapped, so you can see what it looks like, but you want to make sure you wrap your jar in whatever lace you're going to do first, whether it's a heavy lace or a thin lace. You want to cover the entire base so you don't have any glass showing. And then we'll start applying our lace trims to it. So I'm going to start by putting this one on here, which is an embroidered sheer, and I'm just going to put a little bit of glue at one end of the lace here. I'm using my low melt glue gun, and I'll glue this around the bottom. I'm just going to bring this around the jar. You can put an extra little piece on to hold it in place if you feel you need to, but make sure you definitely glue both ends down. Alright, now we're not going to have everything go straight around. We're going to want to have things coming at other angles. So let's use something like this. This is actually half of a cotton collar, and I'm going to wrap this one around at an angle here. So get your placement, and you can see I've overlapped the different laces here. So I'm going to put a little bit of glue on one end. We'll bring this around at an angle and glue it at the other end. Make sure you do not glue your trims up onto the part of the jar here where the lid goes on. If you're going to put your lid back on, you don't want anything getting in the way up here. But we're going to cover the top up separately in a little bit. I'm sorry, I've got some glue on me. All right, so I don't want my collar poking out like this either, so I'm going to put some glue just along the base of it, so I can tamp down my edges, make everything nice and smooth. There's no rules about where you're going to put things, so you just kind of play around with it and do things as you like them. Let's put another piece of natural colored lace on there over the white. So this is a piece of Clooney lace. Let's bring it around from about here. That would be good. And we'll bring it at a different angle here. So I've got a raw edge here. We're going to cover up that a little bit later. I'll show you what we're going to do, but I'm putting a little bit of glue on this, and we'll just tap that down, bring it around to the other end of my collar here, and another piece of glue, and we'll tack that down. All right, let's add some more Venice onto this. This is a Venice lace. This happens to be a length of yardage here, and I'm going to bring this around at an angle here. So just bring it around wherever it looks good to you. Another little bit of glue at one end. Glue that down. And let me see what I'm doing here. Okay, so I'll glue this in the center here. Very fun to make because you can do so many different things with this. If you're making several of them for gifts, you don't need to make them all the same. If you're doing centerpieces for a wedding, again, change them up. You don't want every single one to be the same. Also, remember, when you're sitting at the table, you only see one piece of it. So everybody around your table is going to see another angle of this. So you do want to pay attention to every side of this. I'm going to go ahead and add something right down here to cover up the seam on this, because I don't want it to show. Actually, let's put it somewhere How about right here? That looks good. That way I'm covering up the seam here I had on the Clooney. We'll just bring this down here. This is applique number 7089. Very, very pretty Venise applique. And hopefully that's as straight. Sorry to do it upside down. A little bit of glue at the top and at the bottom. And as you do these and you look at them, if you've got parts that are loose, just come back through and add little drops of glue to tamp them down into place. I've also got, this is a piece of basic polyester lace, and I did a gathering stitch along the top of it using my needle and thread. Let's gather this up on both ends. And I'll just tie this off. Hold on one second, I'll get my hands out of the way. So I cinched that up as tight as I could, and then I'm tying a knot so that this will make a little lace flower. Okay? I'm going to cut off this extra thread. So I've got a little lace flower here. I'm going to put a little bit of glue here to glue the end together. So you can use anything. You can put pearls on these, ribbons. Just mix up your textures, mix up your colors on this so that everything's not white or natural. And then we'll just choose a place and put it on here. You can see some of the ones to the left of me here. We've used burlap. We used pearls. I've got gimp trims on there. All sorts of different things. But this one, because it's gathered, will be three-dimensional and poke up a little bit, which is really nice. But I don't want to have just a plain middle there. So let's put a flower in the center of it. So this is just a small carnation, number 8327. And I'm going to glue that right in the middle. So I introduce some color onto my jar. Same thing a few other places on here. When you start looking at it, you'll find in some of the Venises there may be little spots where you can add a little bit of flower on there. So let's do a couple of extra accents on here. We'll put them couple of spots just to get us some extra color. And you'll be able to turn this around as you're playing with it and see what you want to keep adding or subtracting. I've got this other little shape here that I want to be able to put on here also to be able to fill in this empty spot here. So I'm going to bring this around right about here. This is a little doily. It's a small doily, number 7748. And again, a little bit of glue on the back of it, and we'll just pop that down into place. Let's put a flower in the center of that one so it's not boring. Now, the neck on this, where the lid goes up here, this is really exposed, so we don't want to leave it like that. So we're going to cover this up also. You have one of two ways to do it. You can either decorate around the band here with ribbons and laces and trims, or you could actually decorate around the jar lid. Because if you are going to make this so that you're going to have your seal and your lid on here, you want to be able to decorate it up so it's pretty also. So we're going to put the lid back on this to do that. To decorate my top, I'm going to actually use some ruffled lace. I've got two pieces of style 6095 that's ruffled, and I want to glue these together right down the middle. I'm taking the edge where it's been gathered, and I'm going to glue these down the middle so that I end up with a double-sided ruffle like this. So using my glue gun, again, I'm going to just put a little bit of glue down the middle of this and simply glue my lace pieces together. Do this along the entire length. You're using a low melt glue gun, so only glue a couple of inches at a time. If you do a really long bead, the glue will dry before you get it put together, and then you'll just have to re-glue it. So you don't want to keep applying more and more glue. It'll start getting thick and stiff. So just do a few inches at a time. Glue this along. Okay, I'm going to need to get a new glue stick. Hold on. Make sure you have all your supplies. We don't want to run out as you're making something and you have that best inspiration, right? Alrighty, let's see if this is long enough to get around my top. So I'm going to apply this right around the middle here. That was was perfect. So I'm going to cut off my extra lace. And we will glue this onto the lid of the jar. Again, if you're not going to use the lid of the jar, you can do the same thing and glue it right onto this neck part, you know, the part that has the ridges to put the lid on. Just apply it around that section so that you decorate that up. But do it last, after you get everything else applied. So if you need to camouflage anything else, you can use this to camouflage also. So I'm bringing it around. I'm just going to overlap the end a little bit. I want to cover up this middle part here where I've overlapped the two sections. You can do that by using a strand of pearls or a ribbon, which is what I'm going to use. I'm just going to glue a piece of our, this is 3/16 feather edge ribbon, number 8071. So I'm going to put this right in the middle to cover up the section where the ruffles are. And bring this around every couple inches. Make sure you put a little bit of glue so it stays right where you want it to stay. Just bring, keep wrapping this around. These are very beautiful, and every single time you make it, even if you're using the same laces and trims to make it, you don't have to follow the same pattern, so every single one can be a little bit different. Or you can start with totally new things every time and make them just really, really, really pretty this way. So it gives you a really nice Victorian lacy feel. Okay, so now we've got our top together, so you can see all the different sides look a little bit different. Add as much on here or as little as you want on here. Once you've got everything all done, you can pop your flowers in it if you're making a vase, or you can take the top of this and you can drill a hole in it to be able to make it into a coin jar. They're really very pretty, easy to make, very fun. I hope you like making it. If you have any questions, give us a call. Our phone number is 800-368-3186. Thank you.